Hi, this is Gopal Kamath and welcome to this awesome video. Today I am going to talk about what are the pros and cons of franchising your brand. I am Gopal Kamath, the founder of getyourrestaurant.com. I am a hotelier, restaurant owner as well as a marketer, and today I am going to get to you one of the 8 pros and cons in total of why you should franchise, whether you should franchise, whether you should not franchise, what are the advantages and the disadvantages of franchising your business. So let's start with the pros, that is the advantages. The first and the biggest advantage is you don't have to invest extra capital. It is really a breather for an restaurant owner or a hotelier, or for that matter any business owner who is trying to expand but who doesn't require to take additional liabilities or remove a chunk of his profits which he has earned from a long time and he has accumulated and put in another business. The breather is because each and every investment is a risk. The owner knows that, and if he is taking less risk, it is more easy for him to focus more on the running of the business. So no capital investment is the number one advantage of franchising your brand. The franchisees invest the amount because you are sharing the revenue, you are sharing the profits with them, you are giving them the your name, you are giving them your brand to function in the marketplace and provide products and services and earn a lot of revenue as well as profits. The second thing is the royalty as well as the brand fees. So once you sign up a person or a company for your franchising your outlet or your business, you charge a royalty from the day-to-day profits, but the first thing is you charge a brand fee. So the brand fee depends on how much you are charging and the negotiations with the franchisee. You might charge 5 lakh rupees, 10 lakh rupees, 20 lakh rupees, depending on your brand and how big the investment is. Generally, the rule of thumb is it is somewhere around 5 to 10% of the total investable capital. So let's say the investable capital is around 1.5 to 2 crore, you might charge around 15 lakh rupees for the as a brand fee, and then for the royalty is generally a percentage of the total revenues or a percentage of the profits depending on what business model is. Most of the time in a restaurant it is around 5%, 7% or as high as even 10% of the gross revenues. But it is supported, the revenues which the franchisee company charges is bearable by the franchisee, because the franchise company itself is managing the whole show. The franchisee owner is just like a silent partner. He might come in, he might help a little bit, but most of the show is handled by the franchisee company. That's why they charge a little bit of higher on the gross sales, but it is totally worth it because they have the experience, they have the backup, they have the complete setup, and they know their business more than anybody else. That's why they have franchised it to you. The third thing is expansion. Your brand, the advantage of franchising is you can expand fast, because if you are expanding organically, you might need to take couple of liabilities, and there is a level in till which you can grow. In the franchisee model, the expansion is unlimited. You can grow nationally, you can grow internationally, you can grow throughout the globe. As long as there are people who are ready to invest in your type of business, who are attracted by your business, sky is the limit. I mean, you can expand as much as possible. The fourth advantage is your brand value is strong. So let's say for example, your name gets strong in the whole process of franchising the brand, and the whole name of your organization strengthens by these activities. So you're not putting in any capital at all. You're getting paid by the franchise brand fees as well as the royalty. Your expansion is happening. That means your total turnover of your group is increasing, and that increases your brand name in the whole marketplace. It becomes very attractive for investors who are really looking into grow their money. Big whales and big fishes start looking at you because your whole expansion, the snowballing effects starts happening. It starts rolling into a big snowball. So these are the pros or the advantages of franchising your brand. So now let's move to the disadvantages or the cons of the franchising your business. First is, you have to manage franchises. So if people are not used to interacting with a lot of people, or if you are not used to managing a team, franchising can be really a bad idea for you. If you are a little bit of a lone types, you need to manage these franchisees, because they have invested a lot of money when you have told them to do so. So there'll be a meeting in a year, 6 months, or whenever you go there to that outlet to check out, there'll be a lot of things coming up. You'll be discussing, there'll be a little bit of complaints, there'll be a little bit of compliments. Most of the time it is complaint, but some of the time the compliments also come in. So you need to manage this. It is an additional headache, but then again, if you are getting the pros, you have to take care of the cons. Second is, you have to hire a team. As I said earlier, you have to manage the whole show while expanding, because these franchisees are not equipped, or they don't have the quality of managing the show. That's one of the reason why they are buying your franchise. So you have to hire a team which is in addition to your existing team for your own outlets. So this is a con, because managing a team, again, attrition comes into play. There are a lot of things, internal politics, external politics, then managing the whole show. So you have to bear that, and you have to think of that as a cost of expanding your brand. Third is the accountability. You are accountable. If it is your own show and you are not franchising, 1 or 2 months losses can be bad, because it is your own business. But here, if you don't show any profits, first of all, as I have told you in the other video, if your business is not making profits, it is foolish to franchise the brand, because then you will be expanding zero. Because you are not making profits here and you are multiplying it. So zero cannot be multiplied. So you have to make profits in your original business. Only after that you think of expanding your brand. So accountability comes into play. You are accountable, because the franchisees might give you a little bit of breathing space in order for the business to grow. But at some point of time, they will ask that, why is the business not making profits? And fourth is that you will need to be aggressive. When you are not franchising your brand, sitting with a couple of outlets of your own, you might go for years together without changing your menu or without increasing your things, without evolving. But here, since your expansion, the growth is more and your brand is spread across the globe or nationally or in your state, depending on where you are, you need to be aggressive. You need to be aggressive in promotions. You need to be aggressive as far as the new ideas are coming up, as far as products and services to pitch to the market. Because again, that is tied to your accountability. If you are not more aggressive, you will not make more sales, and then you will not create more profits for yourself as well as for your franchisees. And this will really piss off the franchise. Sorry to use that word. This will piss off the franchisees. They might even go ahead and surrender your franchise. So make sure that you take into account all these pros and cons before thinking of franchising your brand. If you are interested in if you want help to increase your brand, if you are an established franchise company, if you want me to market your brand, just put in a mail or drop in the comment your details, and I'll send you across. I would really love to help you. My expertise lies in promoting a brand, but then the brand should be established and it should be in the expansion mode. I don't work with people who are just starting off with franchising, because then it takes a lot of time to get traction. So I hope you have loved this video. Do subscribe to this channel, share this video with your people, with your friends, and comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you on the other side. Take care. Bye-bye. This is Gopal Kamath signing off. Bye-bye.